you've used the World Wide Web before, right?
I mean, obviously, you're watching this video on a web page right now. And to get to this page, you probably had to navigate through several other pages, like our login page and the page with your learning path on it.
But did you realize that every one of these pages is basically just a document that your computer copied off of somebody else's computer?
That's what we're going to learn about today, how the web and web browsers actually work.
By the end of this lesson, you will be able to explain what URLs are and why they are important, and use browser navigation tools to freely explore the web. Let's get into it. We usually hear the web and the internet used interchangeably, but here's a fun fact. They aren't actually the same. The internet, as you learned in the last lesson, is the network of connected computers around the world. And on each of the computers in this network are tons of files in all shapes and sizes. When we say World Wide Web, we're talking about this web of documents and information all around the world that can be accessed over the internet network. Think of it like this. Every town has roads, but the roads aren't there just so we have something to drive on. We use those roads to get to destinations, houses and stores and literally everywhere. In the digital world, the internet is nothing but a road system. The web, on the other hand, is the collection of destinations you can use the internet to get to, all those files on other computers around the world. Basically, instead of driving down a road to get to the store, you use an internet connection to reach the store's website. Now, let's take the analogy a step further. When we go to a web page, we aren't actually going anywhere. Instead, our web browser sends a request to the computer or server that has the page on it, and that computer sends a copy of the requested page back to our browser. It's kind of like ordering a pizza delivery, except instead of a pizza, the delivery driver brings you a copy of the pizza restaurant's website. But with millions of computers out there in the world, how does our browser know which one to request the page from? The same way you know where the pizza restaurant is. Its address. Every web page has its own address, known as a Uniform Resource Locator, or URL for short. If this video is currently full screen, exit full screen and look near the top of your window. Near the top of the window, you'll probably see something similar to this. That's the URL for the page you are currently on. When you clicked the link for this page, your browser sent a request to the server that this page's file is on, asking it to send you a copy. And clearly it worked because you're watching this video. URLs include a few specific pieces that help the computer locate the page to request. All URLs begin with either HTTP or HTTPS, otherwise known as the URL's scheme. The S in the HTTPS scheme indicates a secure website, which is important when you're entering personal information. Be careful entering information on sites that only use the HTTP scheme, because that means it's a lot easier for your information to be stolen by hackers. The URL's domain is often just the name of the website or the organization behind it. It identifies the group of pages from which you want to copy a specific one. Think of it kind of like how you have to be in the right city before you can even start looking for a specific address. The path is that specific address in the URL. It tells the browser exactly where within the website's files the page you want should be located. For really large websites with lots of branching menus, the paths for their pages can get a little long. And while URLs can make it easy to visit web pages, I don't feel like typing all that in, do you? So instead, let's explore the other tools available in web browsers for navigating between pages quickly and easily. One of the most common ways to access web pages is by clicking hyperlinks, or links for short, which are objects that have URLs embedded in them that directly link to web pages. We typically think of links as clickable URLs, but
Anything can be a link. Text can be turned into a link. Pictures could be a link. I might even be a link. No, I'm not though, so don't try to click on me. That will just pause the video. See? Next time you're on the web, notice how many different things you can click on that link to other pages. As you're browsing through different pages, you might need to go back to the previous page. For that, you simply click the back button. This will go back to the last page you had visited. And if you want to reverse that decision and undo the back button, you can click forward. These two buttons will be used a lot as you move back and forth through web pages. Sometimes you just need to revisit the same page you're on. It sounds weird, I know, but sometimes your first copy of a page has weird glitches. When you click the reload button, your browser requests a new copy of the page, hopefully without the glitches this time. Browsers aren't just capable of one page at a time either. Browsers can open multiple tabs, usually near the top of the browser window, each with different pages on them that you can switch between quickly and easily. And there's no limit to the number of tabs you can have open at once. I mean, theoretically. The more tabs you've opened, the more your computer has to work to keep them open. And what happens when your computer works too hard? With too many tabs open, your computer could slow down and eventually freeze up. Make sure to close any tabs you don't need anymore so your computer doesn't get overwhelmed. If a page is important or you visit it frequently, like a certain online learning platform, you can bookmark or favorite it. This adds it to a list of pages whose URLs are saved in your browser, so you can get back to them easily by clicking their name in the bookmarks list. And if you forget to bookmark an important page, don't worry, it isn't lost forever. Your browser keeps a list of every page you visited in its history. Each browser has a different way to access the history, but it's usually somewhere in the browser's main menu. But saving the URLs of every single page you visit takes a lot of memory and will eventually slow your browser down, just like having too many tabs open. So you should clear your history regularly. Luckily, the button to clear your history is usually right there in the same window. Just make sure to look through it and make sure there aren't any pages you might want to bookmark before you clear the history and lose all those URLs. Phew, that was a lot of information, so let's do a quick recap. If the internet is the roads connecting all the computers of the world, then the documents and files on those computers, the web, are the destinations. Each web page has its own address called a URL that your browser uses to locate and request copies of the pages. And luckily, you don't have to type every page's URL in because browsers include multiple tools, including the back button, tabs, and bookmarks. With these tools at your disposal, you're ready to go out and explore the world. The digital world, at least. In the next lesson, you'll learn how to use one of the oldest and most common forms of online communication, email. Until then, don't forget, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. See you next time! Hey, hey.